everybody. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas welcoming you to the famed New York Arena here in Midtown Manhattan for a much-anticipated main event. This should be a really good matchup here tonight. All that energy that we saw, it almost boiled over at the weigh-in yesterday. Now it gets to explode here in the ring. Hopkins is coming to the ring right now. We know what he offers up once he's inside the ropes, but not much intensity here in this ring walk. David Hayes on his way to the ring. Boy, he looks confident. We've seen it many times with him through the years, but tonight, he's bubbling with confidence.
Introducing first, in the mono corner, with a record of 51 victories, 32 by way of knockout, and 5 losses, hailing out of Philadelphia, the Executioner, Hopkins. His adversary, an impressive record of 25 victories, including 23 knockouts and only one defeat. Coming out of London, David the Haymaker Hayes.
We went over the rules in the dressing room. Let's have a good, clean fight. Touch them up.
Opening 3 minutes of this scheduled 12-rounder. Now, here's what I like about David Haye. He puts his punches together. Great work offensively landing that combination by David Haye.
Get your hands up.
David Haye's on the receiving end of a hook. Hopkins' ability to punch, to flat-out put forth power, puts people in the seats. Early on, that's what they expect to see here.
And early on, sometimes too much of a good thing, guess what? It can be dangerous. It can backfire. If he lands a punch and it doesn't get rid of the guy, well, what else can he do? What happens then?
Good old-fashioned 1-2 by David Haye. Nice work. Very nice work to the head. The right hand landed. Halfway through this round, if there was a baseball umpire around, he'd call that a strikeout by David Haye.
Just like that. Just like that. Get out of the way from those punches. Move your head.
Committing to the body work now. He lands the right hand. Took a shot, now he gives a left. Bernard Hopkins is so dangerous with that accuracy, a two-punch combination landing. Comes right back with a shot of his own. Tremendous pace being set early on here between these two. Can't see this fight going the distance with this pace.
No, not unless something changes, like moving their heads a little bit.
David Haye's on the bad end of a very impressive hook up top. And this round comes to an end. Hopkins' grasp of real estate is something special. Look how he just stays on the outside early on in this fight and is able to find his target.
Well, you're right, Joe. It's prime real estate for him. I mean, he's in the neighborhood he wants to be, on the outside.
Boy, sharp two-punch combination by David Haye. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. David Haye's hurt by a superb hook to the head.
Move those feet.
You see him holding on. Good step back counter punch there. Hopkins is the kind of boxer that wants to do just that. Find the target, get the combination working, land both punches. Well, I hope David Haye trusts in his cut man, because he is dealing with a bad one, and it's right around the eye.
In and out, in and out.
Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. Needs to improve that accuracy, missed with the head shot. Covers up nicely, gets rid of his opponent's body shot. A big right hand.
Stay with him. Stay with him.
And that's the end of round two.
David Haye's head has turned into one big target for his opponent. Teddy, he cannot get out of the way of this attack.
No, he acts like a guy who gets insulted if you miss him.
Start of a fresh round, but I'll tell you this, Teddy. I don't know that we're going to see the end of this round the way he was damaged.
No, I would be surprised. I don't know that he...
Did you see Haye right there? He was rocked. If I was David Haye, I'd look to smother my opponent, make sure he cannot get... Solid! Oh, that's beautiful stuff, Teddy. That is beautiful work with that combination to score the knockdown.
Well, that's the benefit of putting them together. One sets up the other one.
David Haye's corner needs to really get to their man after this round. They need to treat him after that knockdown. They also need to give him some sound advice. What's the advice you'd give him?
Well, first of all, if they're going to get the chance to get to him, he better move his head. But the advice I would give him is, hey, you go out this next round and you kill some time. Tie him up a little bit right from the beginning. Don't worry about losing the early part of the fight or the early part of the...
He returned fire right there, and it worked. After being rocked, now he gets his man.
At this point, it's not about the skills and the abilities of these two fighters. It's about the dreams of them, and one of them is being eliminated.
Now, this is where Bernard Hopkins and all that experience, all that knowledge, it pays off. He found a way to recover and stay in this fight. Nice block by David Haye. This is just beautiful to watch. Watch how he just links one to the next, Teddy. A beautiful sequence, almost like musical notes being played.
Well, exactly. It's a nice tune because it just follows. One, as you said, follows the other. Nice and smooth.
That counterpunch was very effective. He scored well. Nice work by David Haye. Oh, what an exchange! Last 10 seconds of round number three. Hits him in the mug with the right. And the round comes to an end.
That power hand, okay? Keep circling away from that power hand. I need you to keep moving side to side, all right?
He's been on target with his attack. Good, accurate punching as we begin round number four here, and he's up 3-0 on your scorecard, Teddy.
Good counterpunching, and when you're counterpunching the right way, you're usually getting clean shots. He's getting them.
Oh, and they decide to trade there. Lands flush with the combination upstairs. Sharp jab by David Haye. Teddy, do you think the sport needs a national or international governing body?
Yeah, it's the only major sport, at least it used to be a major sport, that doesn't have that. And there's no unilateral control. And when there's no unilateral control across the board, well, you have too many spots, spots that are weak for the sport, spots that do not serve the sport.
Hopkins is doing well here with that two-punch combination. Solid hook upstairs. Watch the hook. Scored well upstairs with the right hand. Another huge shot comes in early on in this fight from him.
Well, he understood that his opponent, Joe, was a slow starter. He's jumping right on him, taking advantage.
Banking away those body shots. Right on the mark with the hook up top. 10 seconds to go in the fourth. David Hayes swinging and missing like he's at bat. Look at that! Oh, this is gonna be close. He may be able to survive the round, but he has gone down now.
One, two, three,
and that's the end of round four. David Hayes' corner has to keep him calm. That's the kind of cut that can send a fighter into fits.
Yeah, and a corner man into using crazy glue instead of adrenaline. I mean, that is a scary cut, as you just said.
Round number five has arrived. Couldn't hit the elusive target with that straight right. That's a fierce left hand that landed by David Hayes. Brings the hook that time. David Hayes now feeling the effects, Teddy, of having his opponent punch right through that guard.
Well, he should feel the effects. I mean, look, Joe, it's kind of like standing out in a rainstorm with an umbrella, and all of a sudden the wind's coming, and the rain's coming from the side, and you're standing there under the umbrella and saying, why am I getting wet? Well, you're standing there covering up. The punches are coming from the side. They're coming from all angles. You're going to get wet.
You're not always protected. Halfway into round number five here.
Keep working it down. Come on, get focused.
Hopkins is landing a combination here. That's what he does when he's at his very best. He took a go of it to the body but came up empty.
It's okay, let's go.
There's the combo to the body. He took a shot, but he came back with a right hand of his own. David Hayes' lack of defense, especially when it comes with just getting away from that right hand, is really costing him a lot here.
Well, it's pretty simple. The old timers would say, move your head, otherwise your opponent will move it for you.
Listen, you get caught up, and your fight is fighting.
Another round, will it go in another one-way direction? It's been a one-sided fight so far tonight.
Come on, get focused!
That is exactly what the corner wanted to see, a good combination punch by David Hayes. Didn't get it done. David Hayes down. He is down, and I don't think he's going to beat the count.
I don't know if he wants to.
One, two,
that's it. Unable to rise up and beat the count. A knockout victory.
Walked right into that one.
Let's make it official. And for that, we send it up to our ring announcer.
The executioner, Hawkins.
That's what you want to see. A guy who can close the show and finish with style. He ends up a knockout victor tonight.
And that's what his trainer wanted. His trainer was even telling him, step it up a little bit, because he knew this was